Is cholesterol important, or how important is it for diabetics? Hello everyone, if you are looking for exclusive deals, blogs, educational content every week delivered to your email, subscribe to our newsletter at sugarmds.com right now. Blood sugar control issues might exacerbate the cholesterol levels. We already know that, right? There's something called diabetic dyslipidemia that occurs when you have diabetes and have low amounts of good cholesterol, but high levels of bad cholesterol and high triglycerides. Remember, bad cholesterol is your LDL and good cholesterol is your HDL. Now, this diabetic dyslipidemia affects up to 70% of people with diabetes. Sometimes, even if blood sugar control is satisfactory, some diabetic patients will still have elevated triglycerides or low HDL, and sometimes higher low-density lipoproteins such as LDL, which is the bad cholesterol, due to underlying insulin resistance or genetic factors. So why does that matter? Well, the National Cholesterol Education Program report from the US and European guidelines actually state that type 2 diabetics is almost at the same risk, or almost they're considered having a cardiovascular disease to begin with. They are at the highest risk category. That's based on the fact that people with type 2 diabetes never had an MI like heart attack before, had the same risk of cardiovascular disease or heart attack as people without diabetes who already had a heart attack at age around mid-50s. So other studies have come to the same conclusions that, you know, a diabetic person who did not have a heart attack is at higher risk of as if somebody who did not have diabetes but had a heart attack already. Some other trials also showed how important for diabetics to control their cholesterol, especially with the increased risk of cardiovascular disease. Their risk is considered tripled in women and doubled in men with diabetes. Now, even after taking into account of age, high blood pressure, which is another risk factor, or smoking, all the other risk factors, and left ventricular hypertrophy, etc., diabetes itself remained a major independent risk factor for cardiovascular disease. Now, over a 12-year period, 10% of the 5,000 men who said that they took medications for diabetes, mostly for type 2, died from cardiovascular disease. Now, in comparison, only 2.5% of the 350,000 men who did not take diabetic medications died from cardiovascular disease. This difference was the same no matter how old they were and what race they were and what their cholesterol level was, or their systolic blood pressure, or if they smoked or not. So when each of these risk factors was added, the risk of heart disease went up more quickly in diabetic men than in non-diabetic men. The Emerging Risk Factors Collaboration Group did a meta-analysis of 102 studies with 530,000 patients who had never had a heart attack, angina, or stroke before in the study. Now, after taking into account and the other risk factors, the overall risk of cardiovascular disease for people with diabetes was twice that of people without diabetes. Now, again, the risk of cardiac death or heart-related death and non-fatal heart attack was also higher, significantly higher, with patients with diabetes. Again, when you have diabetes, your risk of cardiovascular disease depends on so many factors, and you may have to treat all of them. Even though people with diabetes have a higher risk of cardiovascular disease than people without diabetes, the absolute risk has gone down because people with diabetes are now taking preventative steps that are recommended by major societies. Now, even though most of the people in the studies that we discussed have type 2 diabetes, risk of cardiovascular disease, for example, 300 people with type 1 diabetes was actually even higher than in non-diabetics of the same age. So after age 30, the death rate from cardiovascular disease went up quickly, even in that type 1 diabetic group, especially if they also had kidney disease. Now, in a famous study called Framingham Heart Study, the cumulative death rate from cardiovascular disease was 35% by age 55, while it was only 8% in men and 4% in women if they did not have diabetes at that age. Heart attack, for example, did not lead to death, and angina were found to have similar risk. Now, the age a person goes from low risk to high risk with cardiovascular disease is another way to show how dangerous a risk diabetes actually poses for those people. Now, this link was looked at using a large health claims database and group of Canadians from the past, and men and women with type 3 diabetes actually moved into a high risk category, which is defined as 10-year heart attack risk of 20% or more at a younger age than non-diabetic patients. Again, the mean age difference was 15 years, so people who had diabetes in that group had a heart attack 15 years earlier. Again, using a broad definition of cardiovascular disease, the high risk age for men with diabetes was found to be just 41, and for women it was only 48. To summarize, guys, cholesterol, as you know, is a type of fat, just one type of fat that is found in your bloodstream. Now, when you have diabetes, your body may have difficulty processing cholesterol, or it may be genetically related. So you may be dieting, you can be doing everything right, but cholesterol may eventually build up in your arteries, which can increase your risk of heart disease and stroke. Therefore, it is important to pay attention to cholesterol levels, not only your LDL, but also your HDL. More importantly, the LDL, but you need to increase your HDL, lower your triglyceride levels. There are many ways to manage your cholesterol. There are lifestyle changes you can take. There are medications or herbal supplements you can take. Again, having said that, we are almost done creating our herbal supplement that will be an alternative to statins for people who cannot take statins or people who do not believe in statins. So stay tuned on that. It's coming up. So sign up to our newsletter so that you can be notified about that. Just go to sugarmds.com. That way you can help your risk for the serious health complication of heart disease and save yourself for another 10 to 15 years of life, because I'm sure you're looking forward to your grandsons and grandkids to graduate, see their sons and kids, etc. So don't give up. Cholesterol can be as important as your diabetes control, so do not underestimate your cholesterol. Try to keep your LDL below 100, keep your HDL above 50, and try to keep your triglycerides below 150. So thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Hey guys, I hope you are enjoying this channel so far, and I hope you subscribed already. If you didn't, do it. And if you did, watch this video right there. I think that will help you too.